Hi, I'm James Archer from the ShareLingo Project, and today we're going to do a little workshop to help people practice English and Spanish together. And today I have Shanae and Jackie to help demonstrate.
Hello. Hi, Jackie.
So, Jackie.
Yes.
In English, if you don't mind, how long have you been in Denver?
I've been in Denver for 7 years and a half.
Okay. And where are you here from?
I'm from Mexico.
From what part?
Yeah, Mexico City. I was born and raised in Mexico City, yes.
Okay. Well, thank you for being here. Thank you for helping with this. Shanae, what's your story? How long have you, are you
from Denver? I'm from Denver. So mm-hmm. I've been here my whole life since 93, and I speak a lot of English, and I need to learn Spanish.
Okay. But your family?
Yeah, so my dad's family is from Mexico, and my mom's family is from Denver, so I have a mixture of cultures, but I want to connect more with my dad's family and be able to have conversations with like my grandparents and my aunts and uncles.
Yeah,
this is so common. About 30% of our participants are Latino, Hispanic, who want to reconnect mm-hmm. with their heritage. So it's really common. Thank you both.
That's great.
Okay.
We're gonna get it.
Okay, otra vez un poco en español. Estamos aquí para mostrar cómo funciona nuestro taller, nuestro programa para juntar hablantes de inglés y español, específicamente para la práctica, porque hay muchas opciones para aprender más vocabulario. Sí, como Duolingo, Rosetta Stone y otras aplicaciones, uh-huh. pero es difícil encontrar a alguien para la práctica, ¿sí?
Cierto.
Entonces, tenemos un programa específicamente para la práctica y vamos a mostrar todo aquí, o no todo, pero un parte de nuestro programa, muy algo muy, muy fácil. ¿Listas?
Listas.
Ok, so, the way this works is there are 4 parts to this program, but today we're going to talk about just the first 2 parts, mm-hmm. all right? Mm-hmm. Because this is the part about pronunciation and practicing together. So on this page, Shanae, in English, could you please read what is steps 1 and 2?
Step 1 is listen, mm-hmm. and step 2 is to read and pronounce.
Okay, y lo mismo en español, por favor.
Okay. El paso 1 es escucha, el paso 2 es lee y pronuncia.
Por supuesto. Okay, so, if you can imagine being new, a new person here in Denver, mm-hmm. right? Shanae can read in English, right? Mm-hmm. And it would be nice to listen to her English.
Yes.
And Shanae wants to perfect her Spanish. Mm-hmm. So she would like to listen to somebody read Spanish.
Okay.
Makes sense?
Makes sense, totally.
Okay. Yep. So who wants to begin?
I can go. Yeah.
Okay. Shanae, in English then, on the piece of paper, just read, say, the first 2 or 3 sentences on the piece of paper.
Okay. We are Colorado's Latin American Art Museum. Museo has served over 1 million individuals since 1991. Museo is one of 14 Latin American art museums in the U.S.
Great English, right?
Yeah, I love it.
Great English, right?
Yeah.
Okay, Jackie.
Okay.
Now, yes, so she would like to hear your Spanish.
Okay,
right?
Sounds good.
Oh,
okay. Somos el Museo de Arte Latinoamericano de Colorado. El museo ha servido a más de 1 millón de personas desde 1991. Museo es uno de los 14 museos de arte latinoamericano en los Estados Unidos.
Muy bien español. Muy buen español. Ok. ¿Tiene miedo, vergüenza de leer en español?
No.
No, por supuesto, no.
No.
Okay. So are you afraid to read in English?
No.
Because here you are. The two of you are now starting to help each other.
Exactly.
Do you see what's mm-hmm. happening?
Yes,
perfect. We have smiles and it's easy, right?
Yeah.
Okay, now we're going to change.
Okay.
Okay.
And help each other.
Okay?
So the first person is going to read in the target language, mm-hmm. and the other person is going to listen mm-hmm. and think about the words they can help with.
Okay, sounds good.
Okay. En español, okay? Mm-hmm. Ahora vamos a cambiar y ellos van a leer en sus idiomas objetivos, okay? Para, y la otra persona va a escuchar para ver cuáles palabras que pueden ayudar.
Yes.
Más o menos.
Lo dijo bien.
Gracias. Yo también estoy aprendiendo.
Muy bien.
Okay. Somos el Museo de Arte Latinoamericano de Colorado. El museo ha servido a más de un millón de personas desde, I don't know how to say it, 1991. I don't know how to say numbers.
1991.
1991.
Can you see the magic happening?
Yes. I can.
This is the magic. When you practice with a person, you can say, can you say that again? And you don't feel bad. Do you feel bad?
No.
No. Not. You're like, thank you for helping me.
Yeah.
Thanks, right? Jack. Gracias, Jackie.
De nada.
Okay. Museo es uno de los 14 museos de arte latinoamericano en los Estados Unidos.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Good job, right?
Sí. ¿Podría decirle tres cosas?
Sí, por favor.
Cuando tenemos H, H, doesn't sound in Spanish.
El museo.
So, el museo A.
A.
Because you say a little ha.
Okay.
So, A, servido, is no sound in Spanish.
Okay.
And also, millón, es millón. Because it's two L's, es millón.
Millón de personas desde 1991.
Y por último, unidos.
Unidos.
No, you. Es unidos.
Unidos.
That's it. But you did. She rolls the R very well.
She's yes. Her
that's
family
great.
Says yes. Good job.
That's good.
Okay.
How do you feel?
I feel good. I'm gonna need practice with saying numbers.
I'll show you an easy way to do it. So.
Yeah.
Good job. Okay.
Thank you.
Want to try?
So I'll try in English.
Yes.
Okay. We are Colorado's Latin American Art Museum. Museo has served over 1 million individuals since 1991. Museo is one of the 14 Latin American art museums in the U.S.
But from before, there is one thing. I heard you say Spanish.
Exactly. That is Spanish. It's hard for me. When you
know.
Have to use es.
Pero si estoy hablando y yo digo, estoy aprendiendo español. Estoy aprendiendo español. No suena correcto, ¿verdad?
No. You're missing one letter.
Exacto. Pero tú tienes
una extra.
Un extra.
Sí. Exactly. Okay.
You give me your letter, I'll take it.
Okay. Sounds
okay.
Fair.
So, this is the idea. So, what I'm saying here is, Jackie's been here a long time, right? So, her pronunciation is already very good, right? But when you hear those little things like es Spanish, that's a habit.
Yes.
Es un hábito, nada más. Okay? Because she knows. So, how can we help her? We can catch her. Okay? We can say, por favor, dice sabor.
Sabor.
Ahora, San Diego, Santa Teresa.
San Diego, Santa Teresa.
Empiezan con S, ¿verdad?
Yes.
Entonces, en inglés, school, Spanish, some, es como sabor, no como español.
Oh, okay. Perfect.
¿Está bien?
I will keep that in my mind. Okay.
So, what we can do to help. Now, this is the idea. We are here together not so much to learn, if we can think about how can we help the other person.
Yeah.
Okay. When we help the other person, it's not scary.
Mm-hmm. No.
No tenemos miedo de ayudar, apoyar a otra persona, ¿verdad?
It's nice.
And ¿qué va a pasar? What's going to happen? Of course, the other person is going to help us.
Mm-hmm. I like it.
Yeah, it's good.
So, okay, so for this workshop, what we now want to do is bring people into pairs, English speakers and Spanish speakers, and let them try this. First, the first step, what is the first step? Remember,
listen.
It's like listen, escucha. Mm-hmm.
So you're going to listen to your partner read in their language. Mm-hmm. That's our opportunity to listen while we look at the words.
Yeah.
Listening is very important. That's why we listen to the radio, or we listen to shows on television, okay? Because the more we can listen to words, then when it's time to say the word, we have a better idea about how to pronounce the word. Mm-hmm. Listening is really important.
Yeah.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Now what is step number two? Paso número dos?
Read and pronounce.
¿Y cómo funciona? How does it work?
Leer y pronunciar. So you go with the language you're trying to improve, and read on that, and she will correct me, and vice versa.
Right. Right. And in this case, corrections are not bad.
No.
Like, oh, you know, it's good. It's like, oh, thank you for helping me.
Exactly, yeah.
Changes everything.
Yeah.
It changes too. Now, if you do this, imagine this room full of people who do not know each other, and they start to practice together. This is what's happening, I hope, right now. And as they practice together, they smile, and they start to become friends with each other.
That's nice.
Right?
Yeah.
And this is how Museo can help connect the English and Spanish speaking communities here in this room.
Sounds good. Yeah.
Gracias por ayudarnos ahora. Hoy.
Gracias, Shanae.
Gracias, Jackie.
¿Preguntas?
Thank you.
¿Preguntas?
No, no, ninguna.
Okay. Thank you both.
Thank you.
Bye, everybody. We'll enjoy the workshop. And if you have any questions, reach out to us. We'll be happy to do that. And pretty soon, if you want to take this further, Museo is going to have actual courses that run every week where you can do this on a more formal basis. Okay. Si alguien quiere hacer más con este programa, Museo van a tener cursos, ¿es correcto? Sí, cursos cada semana para enseñar, para juntar hablantes de inglés y español específicamente para la práctica. Específicamente, no específicamente.
Específicamente.
Específicamente. Gracias.
Muchas gracias.
Gracias.
Okay.